Alewife, Wikipedia article audio. The alewife is an anadromous species of herring found in North America. It is one of the typical North American shads, attributed to the subgenus Pomalobus of the genus Aloza. As an adult, it is a marine species found in the northern West Atlantic Ocean, moving into estuaries before swimming upstream to breed in freshwater habitats, but some populations live entirely in freshwater. It is best known for its invasion of the Great Lakes by using the Welland Canal to bypass Niagara Falls. Here, its population surged, peaking between the 1950s and 1980s to the detriment of many native species of fish. In an effort to control them biologically, Pacific salmon were introduced, only partially successfully. As a marine fish, the alewife is a U.S. National Marine Fisheries Service species of concern. Alewives reach a maximum length of about 40 centimeters, but have an average length of about 25 centimeters. The front of the body is deep and larger than other fish found in the same waters, and its common name is said to come from comparison with a corpulent female tavern keeper. Description. Distribution. In southwestern Nova Scotia, it is called a keak. In Atlantic Canada, it is known as the Gaspereau, from the Acadian French word Gaspereaut, first mentioned by Nicolas Denis. William Francis Ganong, New Brunswick biologist and historian, wrote, "Gaspereau, or Gaspereaut. Name of a common saltwater fish of Acadia, first used, so far as I can find, by Denis in 1672. Nowhere can I find any clue to its origin. It seems not to be Indian. Acadians named two rivers after the fish, the Gaspereau River in Nova Scotia and the Gaspereau River in New Brunswick. In eastern Massachusetts, Alewife Brook flows through Arlington, Cambridge, and Somerville to the Mystic River. The brook gives its name to the Alewife Brook Parkway and the Alewife Brook Reservation. The Red Line of Boston's T ends at the Alewife Station, so the name of this fish adorns the front of every northbound Red Line train. In the southeast U.S., when sold and used as bait, the fish is often referred to as lee. Both anadromous and landlocked forms occur. The landlocked form is also called a sawbelly or moon eye. In the North American Great Lakes, adult alewives are caught during their spring spawning migration upstream by being scooped out of shallow, constricted areas using large dip nets. They are the preferred bait for the spring lobster fishery in Maine, and are eaten by humans, usually smoked. Alewives are perhaps best known for their invasion of the Great Lakes by using the Welland Canal to bypass Niagara Falls. Alewives colonized the Great Lakes and became abundant mostly in Lake Huron and Lake Michigan. They reached their peak abundance by the 1950s and 1980s. Alewives grew in number unchecked because of the lack of a top predator in the lakes. For a time, alewives, which often exhibit seasonal die-offs, washed up in windrows on the shorelines of the Great Lakes. Various species of Pacific salmon were introduced as predators. Though marginally successful, this led to the development of a salmon/alewife fishery popular with many sport anglers. Conservation. In spite of such biological control methods, alewives remain implicated in the decline of many native Great Lakes species. It is also a common predator of numerous native and non-native zooplankton taxa. Alewife populations have seen big declines throughout much of their range. Several threats have most likely contributed to their decline, including loss of habitat due to decreased access to spawning areas from the construction of dams and other impediments to migration, habitat degradation, fishing, and increased predation due to recovering striped bass populations. In response to the declining population trend for alewives, the states of Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut, Virginia, and North Carolina have instituted moratoria on taking and possession. The alewife is a U.S. National Marine Fisheries Service species of concern, about which the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, National Marine Fisheries Service, has some concerns regarding status and threats, but for which insufficient information is available to indicate a need to list the species under the U.S. Endangered Species Act.